This video is brought to you by The Vine on YouTube and by The Storyteller on Facebook.
Walt Whitman, 1819 to 1892, by Blue, Ontario Shore. As I mused of these warlike days, and peace returned, and the dead that return no more, a phantom gigantic superb, with stern visage, accosted me. Chant me the poem, it said, that comes from the soul of America. Chant me the carol of victory, and strike up the marches of Libertad, marches more powerful yet. And sing me before you go the song of the throes of democracy. Democracy, the destined conqueror, yet treacherous lip smiles everywhere. And death and infidelity at every step. A nation announcing itself. I make the only growth by which I can be appreciated. I reject none, accept all, then reproduce all in my forms. A breed whose proof is in time and deeds. What we are, the nativity is answered enough to objections. We wield ourselves as a weapon is wielded. We are powerful and tremendous in ourselves. We are executive in ourselves, we are sufficient in the variety of ourselves. We are the most beautiful to ourselves and in ourselves. We stand self-poised in the middle, branching thence all over the world. From Missouri, Nebraska, or Kansas, laughing attacks to scorn. Nothing is sinful to us outside of ourselves. Whatever appears, whatever does not appear, we are beautiful or sinful in ourselves only. O mother, O sisters dear, if we are lost, no victor else has destroyed us. It is by ourselves we go down to eternal night. Have you thought there could be but a single supreme? There can be any number of supremes. One does not countervail another any more than one eyesight countervails another, or one life countervails another. All are eligible to all. All is for individuals, all is for you. No condition is prohibited, not God's or any. All comes by the body, only health puts you rapport with the universe. Produce great persons, the rest follows. Piety in conformity to them that like. Peace, obesity, allegiance to them that like. I am he who tauntingly compels men, women, nations. Crying, leak from your seats and contend for your lives. I am he who walks the states with a barbed tongue, questioning every one I meet. Who are you that wanted only to be told what you knew before? Who are you that wanted only a book to join you in your nonsense? With pangs and cries, as thine own, O bearer of many children. These clamors wild to a race of pride I give. O lands, would you be freer than all that has ever been before? If you would be freer than all that has been before, come listen to me. Fear grace, elegance, civilization, delicatessen. Hear the mellow sweet, the sucking of honey juice. Beware the advancing mortal, ripening of nature. Beware what precedes the decay of the ruggedness of states and men. Ages, precedents, have long been accumulating undirected materials. America brings builders and brings its styles. The immortal poets of Asia and Europe have done their work and passed to other spheres. A work remains, the work of surpassing all they have done. America, curious toward foreign characters, stands by its own at all hazards. Stands removed, spacious, composite, sound, initiates the true use of precedents. Does not repel them, or the past, or what they have produced under their forms. Takes the lesson with calmness, perceives the corpse slowly born from the house. Perceives that it waits a little while in the door, that it was fittest for its days. That its life has descended to the stalwart and well-shaped heir who approaches. And that he shall be fittest for his days. Any period, one nation must lead. One land must be the promise and reliance of the future. These states are the amplest poem. Here is not merely a nation, but a teeming nation of nations. Here the doings of men correspond with the broadcast doings of the day and night. Here is what moves in magnificent masses, careless of particulars. Here are the ruffs, beards, friendliness, combativeness, the soul loves. Here the flowing trains, here the crowds, equality, diversity, the soul loves. Land of lands and bards to corroborate. Of them standing among them, one lifts to the light a west-bred face. To him, the hereditary countenance bequeathed both mothers and fathers. His first parts substances, earth, water, animals, trees. Built of the common stock, having room for far and near. Used to dispense with other lands, incarnating this land. Attracting it body and soul to himself, hanging on its neck with incomparable love. Plunging his seminal muscle into its merits and demerits. Making its cities, beginnings, events, diversities, wars, vocal in him. Making its rivers, lakes, bays, embouchure in him. Mississippi with yearly freshets and changing shoots, Columbia. Niagara, Hudson, bending themselves lovingly in him. If the Atlantic coast stretch or the Pacific coast stretch, he stretching with them north or south. Spanning between them east and west, and touching whatever is between them. Growths growing from him to offset the growth of pine, cedar, hemlock, live oak, locust, chestnuts, hickory, cottonwood, orange, magnolia. Tangles as tangled in him as any canebrake or swamp. He likening sides and peaks of mountains, forests coated with northern transparent ice. Off him pasturage sweet and natural as savanna, upland, prairie. Through him, lights, whirls, streams, answering those of the fish hawk, mockingbird, night heron, and eagle. His spirit surrounding his country's spirit, unclosed to good and evil. Surrounding the essences of real things, old times, and present times. Surrounding just found shores, islands, tribes of red aborigines. Weather-beaten vessels, landings, settlements, embryo stature, and muscle. The haughty defiance of the year, one, war, peace, the formation of the Constitution. The separate states, the simple elastic scheme, the immigrants. The Union always swarming with laborers and always sure and impregnable. The unsurveyed interior, log houses, clearings, wild animals. Hunters, trappers. Surrounding the multiform agriculture, mines, temperature. The gestation of new states. Congress convening every 12th month, the members duly coming up from the uttermost parts. Surrounding the noble character of mechanics and farmers, especially the young men. Responding to their manners, speech, dress, friendships, the gait they have of persons who never knew how it felt to stand in the presence of superiors. The freshness and candor of their physiognomy, the copiousness and the decision of their phrenology. The picturesque looseness of their carriage, their fierceness when wronged. The fluency of their speech, their delight in music, their curiosity. Good temper and open-handedness, the whole composite make. The prevailing ardor and enterprise, the large amativeness. The perfect equality of the female with the male, the fluid movement. Of the population. The superior marine, free commerce, fisheries, whaling, gold digging. Wharf hemp cities, railroad, and steamboat lines intersecting all points. Factories, mercantile life, labor-saving machinery, the Northeast. Northwest, Southwest. Manhattan firemen, the Yankee swab, Southern plantation life. Slavery, the murderous, treacherous conspiracy to raise it upon the ruins of all the rest. On and on to grapple with it, assassin. Then your life for ours. Be the stake, and respite no more. Lo, high toward heaven, this day. Libertad, from the conqueror's field return, D. I mark the new aureola around your head. No more of soft astral, but dazzling and fierce. With war's flames and the lambent lightning playing. And your port immovable where you stand. With still the inextinguishable glance and the clinch and lifted fist. And your foot on the neck of the menacing one, the scorner utterly. Crushed beneath you. The menacing arrogant one that strode and advanced with his senseless scorn, bearing the murderous knife. The wide swelling one, the braggart that would yesterday do so much. Today carrion dead and damned, the despised of all the earth. An awful rank, to the dunghill maggots, burned. Others take finish, but the Republic is ever constructive and ever keeps vista. Others adorn the past, but you, O days of the present, I adore you. O days of the future, I believe in you, I isolate myself for your sake. O America, because you build for mankind, I build for you. O well-beloved stone-cutters, I leave them who plan with decision. And science. Leave the present with a friendly hand toward the future. Bravos to all impulses sending same children to the next age. But damn that which spends itself with no thought of the stain. Pain, dismay, feebleness, it is bequeathing. I listened to the phantom by Ontario's shore. I heard the voice arising demanding bards. By them, all native and grand, by them alone can these states be fused into the compact organism of a nation. To hold men together by paper and seal or by compulsion is no account. That only holds men together which aggregates all in a living principle. As the hold of the limbs of the body or the fibers of plants. Of all races and eras these states with veins full of poetical stuff most. Need poets, and are to have the greatest, and use them the greatest. Their presidents shall not be their common referee so much as their poets shall. Soul of love and tongue of fire. Light pierce the deepest deeps and sweep the world. A mother, prolific and full in all besides, yet how long barren, barren. Of these states, the poet is the equable man. Not in him, but off from him things are grotesque, eccentric, fail of. Their full returns. Nothing out of its place is good, nothing in its place is bad. He bestows on every object or quality its fit proportion, neither more nor less. He is the arbiter of the diverse, he is the key. He is the equalizer of his age and land. He supplies what wants supplying, he checks what wants checking. In peace out of him speaks the spirit of peace, large, rich. Thrifty, building populous towns, encouraging agriculture, arts. Commerce, lighting the study of man, the soul, health. Immortality, government. In war he is the best backer of the war, he fetches artillery as good as the engineers, he can make every word he speaks draw blood. The years straying toward infidelity he withholds by his steady faith. He is no arguer, he is judgment, nature accepts him absolutely. He judges not as the judge judges, but as the sun falling round. Helpless thing. As he sees the farthest, he has the most faith. His thoughts are the hymns of praise of things. In the dispute on God and eternity, he is silent. He sees eternity less like a play with a prologue and denouement. He sees eternity in men and women. He does not see men and women as dreams or dots. For the great idea, the idea of perfect and free individuals. For that, the bard walks in advance, leader of leaders. The attitude of him cheers up slaves and horrifies foreign despots. Without extinction is liberty, without retrograde is equality. They live in the feelings of young men and the best women. Not for nothing have the indomitable heads of the earth been always ready to fall for liberty. For the great idea. That, oh my brethren, that is the mission of poets. Songs of stern defiance, ever ready. Songs of the rapid arming and the march. The flag of peace quick folded, and instead of the flag we know. Warlike flag of the great idea. Angry claw, I saw there leaping. I stand again, in leaden rain your flapping fold saluting. I sing you over, over all, flying beckoning, through the fight oh the hard contested fight. The cannons open their rosy flashing muzzles the hurtled balls scream. The battlefront forms, amid the smoke the volleys pour incessant. From the line. Hark, the ringing word charge, dash now the tussle and the furious. Maddening yells. Now the corpses tumble curled upon the ground. Cold, cold in death, for the precious life of you. The angry claw, I saw there leaping. Are you he who would assume a place to teach or be a poet here in the States? The place is August, the terms obdurate. Who would assume to teach here may well prepare himself body and mind. He may well survey, ponder, arm, fortify, harden, make lithe himself. He shall surely be questioned beforehand by me with many and stern questions. Who are you indeed who would talk or sing to America? Have you studied out the land, its idioms, and men? Have you learned the physiology, phrenology, politics, geography? Pride, freedom, the friendship of the land. Its substratum and objects. Have you considered the organic compact of the first day of the first year of independence, signed by the commissioners, ratified by the states, and read by Washington at the head of the army? Have you possessed yourself of the federal constitution? Do you see who has left all feudal processes and poems behind them, and assumed the poems and processes of democracy? Are you faithful to things? Do you teach what the land and sea, the bodies of men, womanhood, amativeness, heroic anger, teach? Have you spent through fleeting customs, popularities? Can you hold your hand against all temptations, follies, whirls, fears, contentions? Are you very strong? Are you really of the whole people? Are you not of some coterie, some school, or mere religion? Are you done with reviews and criticisms of life, animating now to life itself? Have you vivified yourself from the maternity of these states? Have you too the old ever-fresh forbearance and impartiality? Do you hold the like love for those hardening to maturity? For the last-born, little and big, and for the errant. What is this you bring my America? Is it a uniform in my country? Is it not something that has been better told or done before? Have you not imported this or the spirit of it in some ship? Is it not a mere tale? A rhyme? A prettiness dashes the good old cause in it. Has it not dangled long at the heels of the poets, politicians, literates of enemies' lands? Does it not assume that what is notoriously gone is still here? Does it answer universal needs? Will it improve manners? Does it sound with trumpet voice the proud victory of the Union in that secession war? Can your performance face the open fields and the seaside? Will it absorb into me as I absorb food, air, to appear again in my strength, gait, face? Have real employments contributed to it? Original makers, not mere amanuenses. Does it meet modern discoveries, calibers, facts, face to face? What does it mean to American persons, progresses, cities? Chicago. Canada, Arkansas. Does it see behind the apparent custodians the real custodians standing, menacing, silent, the mechanics, Manhattans, Western men, Southerners, significant alike in their apathy and the promptness of their love? Does it see what finally befalls, and has always finally befallen? Each temporizer, patier, outsider, partialist, alarmist, infidel, who has ever asked anything of America? What mocking and scornful negligence! The track strewed with the dust of skeletons. By the roadside, others disdainfully tossed. Rhymes and rhymers pass away, poems distilled from poems pass away. The swarms of reflectors and the polite pass and leave ashes. Admirers, importers, obedient persons make but the soil of literature. America justifies itself. Give it time, no disguise can deceive it or conceal from it, it is impassive enough. Only toward the likes of itself will it advance to meet them. If its poets appear, it will in due time advance to meet them. There is no fear of mistake. The proof of a poet shall be sternly deferred till his country absorbs him as affectionately as he has absorbed it. He masters whose spirit masters, he tastes sweetest who results sweetest in the long run. The blood of the brawn beloved of time is unconstrained in the need of songs, philosophy, and appropriate native grand opera. Shipcraft, any craft. He or she is greatest who contributes the greatest original. Practical example. Already a nonchalant breed, silently emerging, appears on the streets. People's lips salute only doers, lovers, satisfiers, positive knowers. There will shortly be no more priests. I say their work is done. Death is without emergencies here, but life is perpetual emergencies here. Are your body, days, manners, superb? After death, you shall be superb. Justice, health, self-esteem, clear the way with irresistible power. How dare you place anything before a man? Fall behind me states. A man before all myself, typical, before all. Give me the pain I have served for. Give me to sing the songs of the great idea, take all the rest. I have loved the earth, sun, animals, I have despised riches. I have given aims to everyone that asked, stood up for the stupid and crazy, devoted my income and labor to others. Hated tyrants, argue not concerning God, had patience and indulgence. Toward the people, taking off my hat to nothing known or unknown. Gone freely with powerful uneducated persons and with the young and with the mothers of families. Read these leaves to me in the open air, tried them by trees, stars, rivers. Dismiss whatever insulted my soul or defiled my body. Claim nothing to myself which I have not carefully claimed for others on the same terms. Fed to the camps and comrades found and accepted from every state. Upon this breast has many a dying soldier learned to breathe his last. This arm, this hand, this voice have nourished, raised, restored to life, recalling many a prostrate form. I am willing to wait to be understood by the growth of the taste of myself, rejecting none, permitting all. Say, O mother, have I not to your thought been faithful? Have I not through life kept you and yours before me? I swear I begin to see the meaning of these things. It is not the earth, it is not America who is so great. It is I who am great, or to be great, it is you up there, or anyone. It is to walk rapidly through civilizations, governments, theories. Through poems, pageants, shows, to form individuals. Underneath all, individuals. I swear nothing is good to me now that ignores individuals. The American compact is altogether with individuals. The only government is that which makes a minute of individuals. The whole theory of the universe is directed unerringly to one single individual, namely to you, mother. With subtle sense severe, with the naked sword in your hand, I saw you at last refuse to treat but directly with individuals. Underneath all, nativity. I swear I will stand by my nativity, pious or impious so be it. I swear I am charmed with nothing except nativity. Men, women, cities, nations are only beautiful from the nativity. Underneath all is an expression of love for men and women. I swear I have seen enough of mean and impotent modes of expressing love for men and women. After this day, I take my modes of expressing love for men and women in myself. I swear I will have each quality of my race in myself. Talk as you like, he only suits these states whose manners favor the audacity and sublime turbulence of the states. Underneath the lessons of things, spirits, nature, governments, ownerships, I swear I perceive other lessons. Underneath all to me is myself, to you, the same. Monotonous, old song. Oh, I see flashing that this America is only you and me. Its power, weapons, testimony, are you and me. Its crimes, lies, thefts, defections, are you and me. Its Congress is you and me, the officers, capitals, armies, ships, are you and me. Its endless gestations of new states are you and me. The war, that war so bloody and grim, the war I will henceforth forget, was you and me. Natural and artificial are you and me. Freedom, language, poems, employments, are you and me. Past, present, future, are you and me. I dare not shirk any part of myself. Not any part of America, good or bad. Not to build for that which builds for mankind. Not to balance ranks, complexions, creeds, and the sexes. Not to justify science, nor the march of equality. Nor to feed the arrogant blood of the brawn beloved of time. I am for those that have never been mastered. For men and women whose tempers have never been mastered. For those whom laws, theories, conventions can never master. I am for those who walk abreast with the whole earth. Who inaugurate one to inaugurate all. I will not be outfaced by irrational things. I will penetrate what it is in them that is sarcastic upon me. I will make cities and civilizations defer to me. This is what I have learned from America. It is the amount, and I teach it again. Democracy, while weapons were everywhere aimed at your breast, I saw you serenely give birth to immortal children, saw in dreams your dilating form, saw you with spreading mantle covering the world. I will confront these shows of the day and night. I will know if I am to be less than they. I will see if I am not as majestic as they. I will see if I am not as subtle and real as they. I will see if I am to be less generous than they. I will see if I have no meaning, while the houses and ships have meaning. I will see if the fishes and birds are to be enough for themselves, and I am not to be enough for myself. I match my spirit against yours, you orbs, growths, mountains, fruits. Copious as you are, I absorb you all in myself, and become the master myself. America isolated yet embodying all, what is it finally except me? These states, what are they except myself? I know now why the earth is gross, tantalizing, wicked. It is for my sake. I take you especially to be mine, you terrible, rude forms. Mother, bend down, bend close to me your face. I know not what these plots and wars and deferments are for. I know not fruition's success, but I know that through war and crime your work goes on, and must yet go on. Thus by blue Ontario's shore, while the winds fanned me and the waves came trooping toward me, I thrilled with the power's pulsations, and the charm of my theme was upon me, till the tissues that held me parted their ties upon me, and I saw the free souls of poets. The loftiest bards of past ages strode before me. Strange large men, long unwaked, undisclosed, were disclosed to me. Oh, my rapt verse, my call, mock me not. Not for the bards of the past, not to invoke them have I launched you forth. Not to call even those lofty bards here, by Ontario's shores, have I sung so capricious and loud my savage song. Bards for my land, only I invoke. For the war is over, the field is cleared. Till they strike up marches, henceforth triumphant and onward. To cheer, O mother, your boundless expectant soul. Bards of the great idea. Bards of the peaceful inventions. For the war is over. Yet bards of latent armies, a million soldiers waiting ever ready. Bards with songs, as from burning coals, or the lightning's forked stripes. Ample Ohio's, Canada's, bards of California. Inland, bards. Bards of the war. You by my charm, I invoke.
This video is brought to you by The Vine on YouTube and by The Storyteller on Facebook. Thanks for watching. If you like the video, please like, subscribe, share, leave comments, give feedback.